Hello everyone, this is Mamta Mohan and today we'll learn and solve self-practice exercise questions 1 to 4, self-practice 7D of chapter 7, chapter name is Algebra, of class 6th of New Learning Composite Mathematics textbook. If you have not subscribed my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for getting notifications of future videos. Let's get started and solve some questions. What we learn today? Today we learn and solve self-practice exercise questions 1 to 4, self-practice 7D of chapter algebra and chapter and topic is solving equations by inverse operations. Let's solve some questions. Now we solve question number 3B C. 5x equal to 10. Here 5 is multiplied with x. So we have to multiplication with 5. So we have to divide by 5 on both sides of this equation. Now we get 5x divided by 5 equal to 10 divided by 5. Here multiplication 5 is on left hand side. So we have to divide by 5 on both sides of this equation. 5x divided by 5 is x, x equal to 10 divided by 5 is 2. Now we get x value for the variable x is 2. Now we have to check this left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. Now substitute the value x equal to 2 in this equation. 5x equal to 10 on left hand side, 5x equal to 5 multiplied with 2, which is equal to 10. That is equal to right hand side. Now we get left hand side is equal to right hand side. So x equal to 2 is satisfied for this in this equation. X equal to 2 is satisfied in this equation. 5x equal to 10. So we get the value for the variable x is 2. Now solve question number 2B. 45 equal to 90. Here 9 multiplied with t on right hand side, so we have to divide by 9 on both sides of this equation. यहाँ पे 9 multiplied है t के साथ, so हमको divide करना पड़ेगा 9 को both side, left hand side and right hand side. Now we get the equation is 45 divided by 9 equal to 90 divided by 9. And 45 divided by 9 was 5 and 90 divided by 9 was 9 cancel t, 5 equal to t, that is t equal to 5. So t ka value mila 5. Now we have to check this answer by substituting the value 5 for the variable t in this equation, right hand side of this equation, 90. Right hand side 90 equal to 9 multiplied by 5. Which is equal to 45, which is equal to left hand side. So t equal to 5 is satisfied with this equation, 45 equal to 90. So we get the value for the variable t is 5. Now we solve question number 3B. 0.2 y equal to 3. यहाँ पे 0.2 multiplied हुआ है y के साथ, so हमको divide करना पड़ेगा 0.2 on both sides of this equation. Now we get 0.2 y divided by 0.2 equal to 3 divided by 0.2. 0.2 and 0.2 is cancelled. Now we get y equal to 3 divided by 0.2. 0.2 is 2 divided by 10. 0.2 is in decimal, 0.2 is 2 divided by 10. Now we get 3 divided by 2 by 10. That is 3 multiplied with 10 divided by 2. Cancelling 2 is 10, that is 5. Now we get 3 multiplied with 5 is 15. So we get y equal to 15. Now we have to check the value y equal to 15 is correct in this equation left hand side equal to right hand side or not. So substituting the value for the variable y equal to 15 in on left hand side of this equation, we get 0.2 y equal to, यहाँ पे y के जगह में 15 हम substitute करेंगे, 0.22 multiplied with 15 as y equal to 15. Now 0.2 multiplied with 15 is 3, which is equal to right hand side. Now left hand side is equal to right hand side, so this equation is satisfied with the value y equal to 15. So we get value for the variable y is 15. Y equal to 15. Now we solve question number 4th bit. 4th bit is 7n equal to 1.05. यहाँ पे 7 multiplied हुआ है n के साथ, so हमको divide करना पड़ेगा 7 on both sides of this equation. Divide by 7 on both sides of this equation, we get 7n divided by 7 equal to 1.05 divided by 7. And 7 cancel. Now we get n equal to 1.05 divided by 7 is 0.15. n का वैल्यू मिला 0.15. Now we have to check the value n equal to 0.15 in this equation, whether it is left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. So substituting the value n equal to 0.15 in this equation, left hand sides of this equation 7n equal to 7 multiplied with, यहाँ पे n के जगह में 0.15 substitute करेंगे 7n equal to 7 multiplied with 0.15. And 7 multiplied with 0.15 is 1.05, which is equal to right hand side. So we get n equal to 0.15. n equal to 0.15 is satisfied in this equation 7n equal to 1.05. So we get the value for the variable n is 0.15. Now we solve question number D bit. A divided by 2 equal to 8. Here A divided by 2. यहाँ पे 1 divided by 2 divide हुआ है 1 divided by 2. So we have to multiply by 2 on both sides of this equation. Here 2 is divided. So we have to multiply by 2 on both sides of this equation. Now we get 8 divided by 2 multiplied with 2 equal to 8 multiplied with 2. 2 cancel this 2. Now we get a equal to 8 multiplied with 2 is 16. Now we get value for the variable a is 16. Now we have to check the answer by substituting a equal to 16 in this equation on left hand side of this equation, whether left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. Now substitute the value a equal to 16 in this equation. A divided by 2 equal to 16 divided by 2. Substitute a equal to 16, so we get 16 divided by 2 is 8, which is equal to right hand side. LHS equal to RHS. So we get a equal to 16. Now we will solve question number 2nd bit. 15 equal to D divided by 2. Here 15 is on left hand side and D divided by 2 is on right hand side. Here D divided by 2. Here division is here. So you have to multiply 2 on both sides. Multiply by 2 on both sides of this equation, we get 15 multiplied by 2 equal to D divided by 2 multiplied with 2. Cancelling 2 and 2, we get D equal to 30. 30 equal to D or D equal to 30. So we get the value for the variable D is 30. Now we have to check the value d equal to 30 in this equation, whether the equation is satisfied for this value 30 for the variable d or not. That is, left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. So substituting the value for the variable d is 30 in the equation, we get right hand side d divided by 2 is d is 30, we get d equal to 30. So substituting d equal to 30, we get 30 divided by 2, that is equal to 15, which is equal to left hand side. So we get left hand side is equal to right hand side. So this equation is satisfied for the variable d is 30. So we get the value of the variable d is 30. Now we solve question number third bit. N divided by 3 equal to minus 2. यहाँ पे n divided by 3 equal to minus 2 दिया गया है. Left hand side में divided by 3. So we have to multiply by 3 on both sides of this equation. So multiplying by 3 on both sides of this equation, we get n divided by 3 multiplied with 3 equal to minus 2 multiplied with 3. यहाँ पे डिवीजन हुआ है 3 डिवाइड हुआ है n के साथ, सो हमको मल्टीप्लाई करना पड़ेगा. इफ इन दिस इक्वेशन इफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन इज देयर, सो देन वी हैव टू डिवाइड ऑन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन. यहाँ पे 3 डिवीजन हुआ है तो मल्टीप्लाई करना पड़ेगा 3 को. सो मल्टीप्लाई n डिवाइडेड बाय 3 मल्टीप्लाइड विद 3 इक्वल टू माइनस 2 मल्टीप्लाइड विद 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3. Cancelling 3 and 3, we get n equal to minus 2 multiplied by 3 is minus 6. Multiplication of minus and plus is minus. Now we get the value for the variable n is minus 6. Now we have to check the value n equal to minus 6 in this equation by substituting whether this equation is satisfied or not. That is, we have to check left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. So we have to substitute the value n equal to minus 6 in this equation, that is left hand side n divided by 3, substituting n equal to minus 6, that is minus 6 divided by 3 equal to minus 2, which is equal to the right hand side. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So this equation is satisfied with the value n equal to minus 6. So we get the value for the variable d and value for the variable n is minus 6. Now we solve question number 4th bit. 1.8 m equal to 36. This is the equation given and we have to solve the value for the variable m. So here 1.8 multiplied with m, multiplication operation is given, so we have to divide by 1.2 on both sides of this equation. So we have to divide by 1.8 on both sides of this equation, we get 1.8 m divided by 1.8 equal to 36 divided by 1.8. Cancelling 1.8, we get m equal to 36 divided by 1.8. That is 36 divided by 1.8 is 18 divided by 10. That is 36 division of 1.8 is 18 divided by 10. That is 36 multiplication of reciprocal of this fraction 18 divided by 10 will be 10 divided by multiplying with reverse of this fraction, that is 10 divided by 18. Now 18 multiplied with 2 is 36. That is, we get 2 multiplied with 10 equal to 20. We get 20, m equal to 20. So we get the value for the variable m is 20. Now we have to check the value m equal to 20 in this equation, whether this equation is satisfied or not. That is, the value m equal to 20, we have to check the left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. That now we have to substitute m equal to 20 in this equation on the left side of this equation, that is 1.8 equal to m. Here we have to substitute m equal to 20, that is, m is 20, 1.8 multiplied with 20. M equal to 20, so we have to substitute m equal to 20 here. Now 1.8 is 18 divided by 10 multiplied with 20. Now cancelling 10 with 20, we get 2. That is, 18 multiplied by 2 is 36, which is equal to the right hand side. Here 1.8 m equal to 36, that is equal to 36. We get here 36, which is left hand side is equal to right hand side. So this equation is satisfied with the value m equal to 20. So we get the value for the variable m is 20. The solution of this equation is m equal to 20. Subscribe my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel, and if you have any doubts, then please write in comment section and I will reply. Keep learning, keep watching, and please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you. If you like this video, then please click the like button and share this. If you have not subscribed my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for getting notifications of future videos. If you have any doubts, then please write in comment section and I will reply. Keep learning, keep watching, and thanks for watching. Please subscribe my YouTube.